gonna be a cool experiment into seeing how adapted lenses perform, both for photo and video. On here right now, I have an adapted Minolta 35mm f2.8. I also have an adapted Leica 35mm f3.5 lens. Nash right now is shooting on an adapted 35mm Mamiya Secor lens. So, moral of the story, the entire video is being shot on adapted 35mm lenses. Let's go see how they do. Oh God, the focus ring is locking up on me right now. This was originally my grandfather's lens. I believe he bought this in like 1960 something. So it's definitely showing its age. An interesting test that's going on right now is with everything going on and using a manual lens, I feel so sped up since, you know, usually you're shooting digital and there's a lot more just like opportunity to just fire off a bunch of shots, but I'm having to like limit myself, but also not hold myself back too much. I don't know, it's a very interesting way to kind of slow down the way that you shoot on digital. I feel like if anything, this video is gonna be a showcase of the video that you get. In my mind, it's like I'm shooting 35 millimeters, but since it's being thrown onto a crop sensor lens like this one, you still have to do the like multiplication of, it's like a 1.6 or 5 crop factor. So even though this is like a 35 millimeter lens, you're only getting the frame of like a 50 millimeter, 50, 58, something in that range. And so I keep thinking like, oh, this is perfect, because I know what 35 millimeters is supposed to look like. But then I look and I'm like, no, that is way more zoomed in than I imagined it being. You think it'd be a good time to switch? There we go. So as you can see here, we have this goofy looking Leica lens. Unlike the Minolta lens, it has this little itty bitty focusing lever thing. And of course, I had to throw the broken light meter on the hot shoot just because. I find I'll forget to focus and then I'll take the shot and I'll go, oh shit. And then I'll take another one and then I'll overcorrect my focus and I'll take another one. So it is still a very, not an acquired taste, what? It's an acquired process. I don't know, whatever. Something that's really saving my ass right now is focus peaking. Because the focus is so soft on these lenses, it really helps having the camera be able to tell me what I'm focused on, because especially on such a tiny screen, it really helps to have that just like confirmation that you're focused on the right thing. I think I lied about the focus peaking thing. It just makes me even more confused. What the hell? As nice as it is being able to shoot film emulations, the fact that you can only use them in JPEG is a real bummer, because I find myself going out and being like, oh, I'm gonna shoot everything, but you can't really edit a JPEG super well. You miss exposure on a JPEG and you're like, ah, damn. You just like throw in the towel. Adapted film lenses and film emulations, they have their time and place. But like, that's about it. It's not really an everyday carry type situation. If you have the lenses laying around, dropping 20 bucks on an adapter is totally cool. Even if it means you just get like a couple photos out of it. But I wouldn't like orient your entire like shooting style around using adapted lenses, if that makes sense.
Now, okay. Yep. Minor details. Yep, yep, important. So far, I really like the look of this 35 millimeter Mamiya. Overall experience is good. I think with this lens and this scenario, it's definitely a little challenging. So many moving things, focusing on Matt while trying not to run into 10 different people in the market, and it being a 35, not being able to go wide, that was a weird hand motion, not being able to go wider than 35. But overall, it's a great lens. I think I'm gonna shoot a short film on it next week. Thanks for letting me use it, Matt.
Shout out to Nash for recording this. All the links are gonna be down in the description. I have presets, prints, all of that fun stuff. go check it out down there. Nash's links are gonna be in the description as well. Have a good weekend, everybody.